Hi, I'm Daniel Weisberg, Search Advocate at Google, and welcome to another Search Console training episode. Today, I'll discuss how to export your Search Console data to spreadsheets and give you some ideas on what to do with it. One advantage of exporting the data is that it allows you to add more context to your reports. You can enrich the data with any sources, like technical or business information about your site. Another advantage is that it allows you to do more advanced analysis using the data, using statistical or data visualization tools. Search Console provides you data to help you understand your performance in Google Search. But the tool is built for users that work with many different types of websites. So the charts provided in the tool might not be exactly what you need. Or maybe you need to prepare something for others involved with the website, maybe for the marketing team or for a manager. If that's the case, you might want to set up a custom dashboard with data visualizations that are not supported by Search Console, such as maps, area charts, scatter plots, pivot tables, or tree maps. These might help you make better decisions that are supported by data. To make a custom dashboard, you'll need to export your data. Let's start with the easiest way to export data from Search Console: spreadsheets. In most reports, you'll find an export button, usually in the top right corner. In this example, we're looking at the search performance report, which I discussed in a previous episode of this series. When you export data, you can choose among three options: Google Sheets, Excel, or CSV. Click one of the options to export the data in your preferred format. Any filters applied to the current report will also be applied to the data exported. The export feature built into reports allows you to export 1,000 rows of data. For the performance report, you get 7 different tables when you export the data, corresponding to the different tabs in the report, plus a futures table that lists the futures that were applied to the data exported, such as the search type and date range. Different reports will have different tables, so it's worth taking some time to go over the information you can export. Exporting data can open many doors, metaphorically speaking, of course. Let's discuss two examples showing how you might use this data to make better decisions. In the first example, suppose you have a website divided into multiple sections. For instance, if you have a bookstore, you'd probably have sections for poetry, fiction, sci-fi, arts, and so on. This might or might not be visible in the URL structure, but usually websites would be divided into different directories, in which case you would see bookstore.com/poetry/fiction/sci-fi, and so on. If that's the case for you, you might be interested in comparing these sections for the metrics available at Search Console, along with internal metrics your company has. For example, number of books available, average book price, and profit metrics. The table you see was created by exporting data for our developer documentation using the Search Console Performance Report and joining it with additional data. Let me go through the process I used to create it. Our developer documentation has two main directories called docs and blog. We want to compare views between pages in those two directories. If you use directories, you can use the split function in Google Sheets to break apart your pages by directories. If you do not use directories for your website sections, you would need a table that shows, for each page, which section it belongs to. This sheet shows an example of such a table. The Search Console export provides performance stats on a page level, including all the columns you see, apart from the section column. To create a table where you have both the performance data and the sections, you need to join the tables using a VLOOKUP function. To do so, let's add a column to the top pages table that we exported from the performance report and name it Section. The VLOOKUP function finds the matching category for each row in the pages table from the possible categories listed in the sections table. In other words, you're joining the two tables using the page as the key. If you're not used to spreadsheet formulas, it may look a bit daunting at first, But you can remake the spreadsheet at any time, so just try it out. And make sure to check out the links in the description to learn more about Google Sheets. In a second example, suppose you're analyzing your search performance for the countries that are most important to you. This might help you evaluate your past budget and decide where to concentrate your future SEO effort. In this table, I joined the performance data to the country budget and the region, also using the VLOOKUP function, just as I did in the previous example. With this data, you can analyze your regional SEO budget and decide how to distribute it. For example, you could build a chart showing the total budget for each of the regions and how much traffic you're getting from them. You could also try and assess how big an opportunity each market has by looking at metrics like average position and click-through rate. This information could help you distribute your budget in a more informed way. For example, if you find out that there is a significant opportunity in a non-English market, you could increase your website translation budget for specific languages. I hope you have a few of your own ideas about exporting your data out of Search Console. In the next video, we'll discuss ideas on how to monitor your search traffic. That can help you make your search performance data more clear and actionable. Stay tuned. Exporting data can open many doors. Metaphorically speaking, of course. That's a horse. That's not a door. That's better.